I forgot to check what day it is, but anyways, I think it's the, the 30th of the month. It's December 30th, so it's, my name day, actually. My name day is, Prophet Daniel. That's today. Once again, I am in oscillating sleep mode. And so, while I'm up now, I had something to eat, watched a bit of TV. The vlogs I watched on the YouTube Stroll. There's enough Christmas content that watching people opening presents and sort of talking about their Christmas that it will last me well into the Eastern Christmas on January 7th, which also is George, ironically enough, is George Washington's Christmas. It's the original American Christmas. So the Americans used to celebrate at the time of George Washington used to celebrate Christmas on what would be January 7th. So back then it would have been December 25th, but that December 25th, when they were celebrating Christmas, now falls on January 7th. So still yet to come. Merry Christmas to George Washington. So we're beginning our vlog for the day for Wednesday. There's still an enormous amount left to do. It's going to be an oscillating mode. It means I'm going to be awake for a bit, asleep for a bit. Awake for a bit, asleep for a bit. In other words, the sleep pattern is going to be completely thrown off. We'll see what happens with work. Now we're operating in something called emergency mode. Once that happens and the schedule is thrown off, there's nearly no way to predict what's going to get done, how it's going to get done, or anything like that, because there's no fundamental schedule. I just thought of something. I can check and see what day it is today. I have other tablets here. Yeah, December 30th. I was right. We can sort of figure out how things are going to work to a certain degree. It's a matter of not knowing exactly what's going to happen. And so what happens when I get up? I have a list of things to do that need to get done. And so I'm up now. I run through a bit of the list now. Go back to bed. When I get up again, I'll run through another list of work. A list of sort of items that need to be done. And then I'll be tired enough, I'll end up going back to bed. Then that pattern repeats itself for the rest of the day. That's what I'm saying. Oscillating means it goes up and then down. Up and down. That's an oscillation. And it's also based on the circle. So it repeats itself here, gets to the point here, and goes back again. So that's also oscillating as well. And there's nothing I can do about it. That's just the way things are, and it's a matter of sort of adjusting to the environment that allows me to make the day either successful or not successful. But I've already got a certain amount of work done. I'm ahead in some aspects of things, so it looks like it's going to be pretty good. It just sort of really depends on how, well, so the rest of the day goes, but this is the beginning. So I will probably see you in a bit for the next time I'm up. I have to do some gaming now. That will give me another 12-hour window, so I won't have to do anything after that. And then, it'll be back to bed. What do I say? It's a little after midnight. It's 22 minutes into the 31st day of December 31st. It is the day of New Year's Eve. And New Year's Eve is going to be like everything else for me. It's just going to be basically another day. I spend most of my life doing research. I spend most of my time doing research. That's what it is that I do. And I at a point where I have no idea where the research is going to end. I have no idea where the research is going to take me. There are days where you look for even minor achievements, but that's actually, but more often than that, so you can get minor achievements. And then you have larger goals that occasionally occur. But every time you level up, every time you do better and move up to the next level, there is so much more work to be done. It's not, you actually haven't reached an end, and I said there, you can level up for forever and simply never get to the end. And you kind of get used to that to a certain degree. And so when you watch some, when I have my YouTube stroll right now, that's what I'm doing, is watching my YouTube stroll. But I take a leisurely, when I'm doing the YouTube stroll, it is what it is. It is a stroll. I'm not going through there quickly. I'm just sort of leisurely walking my way through the YouTube neighborhood, the one that I chose. And the path I chose is the Yowie Vlogs in the beginning. And then I go over to It's Our Life. And then from It's Our Life, I go to the Leroy's. From the Leroy's, I go to ourfamilynest. And from ourfamilynest, I go to Family Five Vlogs. And from there, I end up going to Clintus. And the standard path there, that becomes my routine. And there are a lot of, I have subpaths that come off of there, but I typically go through my routine first, and when I get to the end of my routine, then I go down to the subpaths, and that's Kesley's channel, that's Carly Reese's channel, that's Allie the Rose, Savannah also is now posting. You have a number of, Evie and Capri are posting every once in a while. There are sort of sub paths that you can go down, and then they have friends, and you go to, I add to the paths channels that are in the same neighborhood. Let's say It's Our Life is in Florida, so I have two other channels, the family channels that do posting vlogs, and they're also in Florida. So the Florida path is It's Our Life, so It's Our Life is also the Florida path. Family Five Vlogs, there are other family vlogs as well. This includes the McNeil family. Clintus always had the RVing, so the RV path is down Clintus, is down the Clintus path, so is Sierra. So you have a number of different, sort of, if someone's not posting every day, or there's sort of a shortage of things, you can always go down that other path, these other paths as well. And this provides you with your routine. And then when I want to, if I have enough time, I can go ahead and watch my what's on my library, and that's Kim Possible. I have Codename Kids Next Door. I have Johnny Test, and a whole list of cartoons I can go watch. And then I have a list of anime. My anime choices are again off path. I don't have a standard choice. I'm not sort of with the crowd, if you will. My path is, again, like my vlogs, I prefer the conversation. If there's conversation is there, there's a good conversation, that's what I like. I'm there for the conversation. And most of the channels that I have, all the channels I have, the conversation between the family is very good. I find that conversation entertaining. But, you know, everyone has their own particular taste, everyone has their own particular views. And there's a sort of like a mid segment here, because today it was just mostly a sleeping day. I needed to catch up on my sleep from the weekend. Well, actually, I did this week two all nighters, and I was never able to catch up on my sleep in terms of the sleep deprivation clock sort of crept up on me. And so I went into a bit of a crash today. But again, even there, when you go back and when you go talk about part of the experience, and part of the experience is because I'm a lucid dreamer, my dreams are part of my experience. And the thing is, as this occurs, as your life goes on as such, what you experience in your dreams does play a factor in how you experience life when you're awake. And so you have good days, you have bad days, you have in-between days. The experiences last night and the last few days were kind of interesting. Again, a lot of times it brings out a lot of different fears, a lot of different sort of anxieties are brought out in your dreams that you simply don't deal with during the day, or sort of they're pushed aside. So that's why you don't deal with them. And it brings out the ability to develop and understand that maybe you didn't have before. And the thing is as much as you think you've conquered something, the dreams tell you, because in many cases it'll be the same theme over and over and over again, presented in different ways. You might find something that almost every time you get into a dream, you've improved, you've changed, but there's still a lot more to do. In other words, your progress is fractional. And every time you hear me say fractional, talk about something that's being fractional, what you need to understand is that's the fractional is the code word for calculus. Calculus is basically the fractional mathematics. It is how close can you get by fraction to a particular asymptotic point, a point that's infinite in distance. If something is infinite in distance, you never actually approach it. You never actually reach it. You only approach it, and you approach it by fractions. As your fractions of sums add up, that gives you your progress. And this is sort of the way knowledge works. Knowledge is, again, it's fractional. You never get anything absolutely right. You get it approximately right. So some things will work okay, and some things won't work all right. But it really depends on how you approach things, where your views are, how you understand something. And because you're always missing aspects of things, your understanding will never be perfect, will never be the main thing that you're looking at. It will always be a sub-component of whatever you're looking at. Anyways, that's it for now, and I'll probably come back around 6, 7 o'clock in the morning to end the day, and then a little later on to begin the day.
There's the bus.
Well, I'm not necessarily too sure where we are in terms of the clip status, whether at the beginning, I can't remember whether I started earlier today or not. But we do have a package open. It is 16 hours and 5 minutes into the 31st day of December. That is a Thursday. And we have a package opening. The package came in today. I'm not really too sure what it is, but we will certainly find out. Thought that would be sufficient, but it wasn't. There we go. Something ordered two of, I guess. So let's take the packaging out. Looks like it's something for cooking. Oh, okay, these are... These are things for Nespresso. I ordered my mom an espresso machine. Our Christmas is still to come, so I ordered that for Christmas. And so these are the Nespresso cups. So it gives you a scooper. I guess this is a brush. Seems to be really tight in there. All right, here we go. It is a package of three cups. The cups themselves are plastic, but the top is metal. So this is the one I ordered. This is the ones I ordered. Plastic, metal on top. Not really too sure how to open this, but anyways. Once I figure out how to open it and how it works, I'll let you know. Anyways, that's what came in. That's the package opening for today. I'm expecting another package, so maybe today, because it says out for delivery. It'll be my food dehydrator, but hasn't come in yet, so either today or maybe Monday, because tomorrow's January 1st, and people I'm pretty sure aren't working then. Tomorrow on Friday, so we'll wait till Monday to see what we get. Alrighty, see you then. Well, not Friday, but a little bit later. We are back, because I finally figured out how to open it. It wasn't too quick, it wasn't too long afterwards. So, it's this little brush here. It comes with there's a little brush here, and that's the only one that has that brush. Let's see if I can get a better shot of it. There we go. There's the brush. I couldn't figure out what this end was for, but I realized that now that I've got this open, and it opens like this, so here's the metal top. Here is the actual container, which is plastic. When you close it like that, it snaps shut, and it's very hard to get open with your fingers. But if you take the tip like this, and you put it underneath the metal part of the lid, was working. There we go. So, like this. There we go. So, now it opens easier. You need this tool to open up the refillable coffee containers. So that's how that works. And now that you've got that little tidbit of information, you're just waiting for the Nespresso machine to come in, probably in a couple weeks or so. And we'll go from there. Alrighty. See you later.